Intense manhunt underway tonight as state troopers search for a man accused of killing one of their own.
They are looking for this guy, 31-year-old Eric Frein, a sharpshooting survivalist considered armed and extremely dangerous.
Good evening, everyone. Frein is wanted for an ambush that killed one state trooper and injured another.
It happened Friday night at the state police barracks in Blooming Grove. That is about 5 hours east of Pittsburgh. Ralph Iannotti is live with more on this developing story. Ralph.
Well, thanks very much, Susan. There's absolutely no doubt about it, especially for people in law enforcement. This crime had a ripple effect across the Commonwealth, and we are learning a lot more tonight about the prime suspect and chilling new details on his background. While state police helicopters search from above, hundreds of law enforcement officers have fanned out in and around the dense woods in rural Pike County. They're looking for this guy, 31-year-old Eric Frein, identified today as the prime suspect in the ambush shooting.
We don't know where he is, so we're going to look everywhere. This fella is, we've said, is armed and extremely dangerous, so I mean, people should take caution.
In the small community of Blooming Grove, not far from the state police barracks where the two troopers were gunned down, there's an air of apprehension.
We're keeping our heads up, our eyes and ears open, and making sure that we're safe.
Like nothing you've never seen before. I mean, helicopters, just police presence everywhere.
According to court documents released today, police recovered a sniper training and employment manual in Frein's bedroom in the house where he lived with his parents. His father, an Army vet, said that his son was an excellent marksman who, quote, doesn't miss. We've also learned tonight that Corporal Dixon was shot twice and that troopers used a patrol car as a shield so they could drag Dixon into the barracks after he was shot. Frein is described as a survivalist who has publicly expressed a desire to kill law enforcement officers and commit mass murder. He was positively ID'd after police got a tip about a Jeep partially submerged in a pond not far from the state police barracks. They found shell casings inside the Jeep matching those discovered at the crime scene.
Also found in that vehicle, the defendant's Social Security card, a game commission range permit for the defendant, camouflage face paint.
Now, Trooper Alex Douglas, who was wounded in the ambush, continues to recover tonight, and the funeral for Corporal Brian Dixon, a Marine Corps veteran, is set for Thursday in Scranton. We're live tonight. I'm Ralph Iannotti, KDKA TV News.